Without the ocean, there is no life.
While Bill was developing business cases for Vancouver Island, he learned that seaweed was going to change the world. After an hour on the phone with one of Canada's most knowledgeable seaweed experts, Bill's entrepreneurial spirit was sparked, not because he needed a new project, but because of the positive social, environmental, and economic benefits this budding sector offered. Seaweed farming helps feed our growing populations, helps revitalize coastal communities, and reverses human impact on the oceans. Only 2% of our global food production comes from the ocean, but oceans cover 70% of our planet.
Seems like a no-brainer to me.
Welcome. I'm Christine Cuvelier of Culinary Concierge. As an executive chef and Canada's leading global culinary trendologist, I think about and taste the future of food. I help my clients launch on-trend, on-time, great-tasting food and menu items. The definition of innovation is the introduction of something that tastes great, is good for you and good for the planet. And you know that could be the definition of seaweed. Cascadia Seaweed are leaders in the rising tide of seaweed innovation. For the past few months, I've been experimenting in my test kitchen, making products with seaweed in them that taste great, that are good for you and good for the planet. For the Seaweed Festival, I reached across Canada, coast to coast, and talked to all my chef friends. They've been experimenting in their kitchens with Alaria and sugar kelp. Every day for the next 7 days of seaweed, log on, watch a chef video, be inspired by their recipes. Let's make this the year kelp is cool. And don't forget, it's all about taste, taste, taste.
Today we are going to do a simple dish with wild salmon from BC. That's a Chinook. We are going to use a compound seaweed butter. So the seaweed are coming from Cascadia seaweed. And today we are going to use Alaria and a sugar kelp seaweed. When I cook, you are going to see the cooking is going to be very fast. It's very, we keep it very fresh. Everything is fresh. The produce are very important. So we have some seaweed. So the seaweed from Cascadia who are outstanding, like the Alaria and sugar kelp. Sugar kelp, it's a little bit, for me, has a little bit more flavor. When we are going to do our compound butter, which is here, ready to go, which is very easy to do, we are going to use, we have some dry mix of seaweed, the Alaria and the sugar kelp from Cascadia. So we are going to use both dry seaweed and the fresh seaweed. The fresh seaweed, I blanch it a few minutes. I would say in boiling water, always boiling water, and cool it down very quickly. The same thing, same way we will cook greens vegetable. So we blanch it very quickly, like two minutes max in boiling water, and we cool it down. So as I say, in the compound butter, I use dry Alaria and sugar kelp, and I'm going to use fresh Alaria and sugar kelp also, who has been blanched. In the mix, I'm going to use some parsley, some coriander. I'm going to put a little bit of pickled ginger, and I'm going to do some also some onions and green onions. Again, when you cook, you really you can change the ingredient. Like in a way, if you like chive, you can put chive instead of parsley. If you like tarragon, you can put tarragon. We are going to have a little bit of pecan also. So we are going to do this very, very quick dressing that you can use it and keep it all the time on top of the compound butter, okay? So let's do the mix first before we start cooking. So as I say, our compound butter, as you can see, I roll it. So there is fresh seaweed, there is dry seaweed, butter, pickled ginger, some pepper, black peppercorn. Yeah, green onions. So, but you can put, as I say, you can play with the herbs. Okay, let's put that on the side. Okay, so I prepare my salmon. I keep, you see, I kept the skin on the salmon. I did a little bit of tornado, little one. So we are going to cook it at what we call unilateral. So it means we are going to start with a cold pan. We are going to have some olive oil. We are going to cook on the skin. Then we are going to cover. We are going to cook all the way on the skin. It's going to be very fast, maximum five minutes. You want to keep the salmon a little bit medium rare. But first, we are going to do what I said before, our mixed of like our little dressing. So what I have, and this one you can use it before, you can prepare it before and finish and keep it in the fridge. As you see, very thin. I had some sweet potatoes. I had some red and orange pepper that I blanched before. Again, little bit of pickled ginger, some coriander stems, some little bit of parsley. What else? We are going to put some pecan, a few pecan, and that's going to be our sauce after that we are going to eat with the pompon. We are going to put a little bit of pepper, crushed black peppercorn. We are going to put some of the fresh seaweed. So those seaweed have a little bit of salt, because they are coming from the sea, from the ocean. So we are going to put some of chopped seaweed. Now we are going to have some olive oil, and we are going to get some maple syrup. When you do a dressing, it's always the same proportion. So it's always one spoon, one part of lemon juice. I don't use a lot of vinegar, but so a little bit, one part of lemon juice. We are going to put one part of maple syrup, and we are going to put three parts of olive oil. Try to use the best olive oil that you can all the time. So three parts. So if we do one spoon, you do one spoon of lemon, you do three spoons of olive oil, or any kind of other oil. Could be grapeseed oil, but make sure you use a very good oil with a lot of fruit, lot of perfume. And that's going to be our little dressing. Make sure you prepare it before, so like that all the flavor marinate together. So to do the compound butter, as I say, you put in the RoboCoupe, in the mixer or whatever. If you don't have RoboCoupe, you can do it by hand. You just do it the bowl. Always have some soft butter and mix your chopped herbs, whatever you want on it. There is a chemistry between the salmon and all the ingredients, the maple syrup, the little bit of pepper, the sweet potatoes. All those ingredients are food that goes well together, and we help to think also about the food and wine pairing, so what will go well with this one. So definitely we go with a nice Chardonnay that will go well with our salmon. So we have our things. Now we are going to start cooking. We are going to put a little bit of olive oil in the pan, and we are going to put our salmon. Now I'm going to have on my salmon, I'm going to have a little bit of spicy peppers from Italy, we are going to put a little bit of maple syrup. So we have, in a way, a spicy, a little bit sweet and spicy maple syrup with what we call bomba italiano, like some little spicy peppers. We don't need salt because we have already salt in the seaweed, in the butter. We are going to put a little bit of some pepper on top. We are going to put some butter, the seaweed butter, which is very soft, as you can see. So this one. So when it's going to start cooking, the butter is going to start to go inside and to give the flavor of the seaweed, the sugar kelp, and the alaria from Cascadia seaweed. So you see, you can put your things here. Make sure that it's separate. Now on top of this butter, we are going to put some of my maple spicy syrup. You see? So it's going to cook all together. Okay. Now I'm going to have two of my little tornado. And again, some pepper. Okay, so, and I'm going to put a little bit of salt on this one. It's my frozen lemon. Okay, so I always have that in my freezer. So when you do lemon, frozen lemon, you put everything. Okay, a little bit. So everything goes. Little bit on the salmon. And we are going to put more at the end. Just to keep a kick. Okay. So from this point, the cooking part is going to be very fast. So as you see, I cut a nice, the same size of the salmon steak, and I have two little tornadoes. That's going to help me for the presentation. I have my my compound, like my crudités, in a way, ready to go. It's marinated now. It's getting some flavors. Okay, there is the seaweed inside, the alaria, the sugar kelp, and we have seaweed butter on the salmon. Later on, when we are finished, we are going to put a little salmon butter on the tornado. I will say medium heat. Again, so we are cooking on the skin. So the skin is going to protect all the meat. After the skin, we want it. I mean, you can eat it, but it's really not the purpose. The purpose of the skin is to protect the salmon. So we are going to cook it slowly. What we are going to do, we are going to cover it. And it's going to cook for probably, I would say, 5-6 minutes. So now for the presentation of the plate, I mean, it's just, I'm going to show you one example, but doesn't have to be exactly the way I'm doing. But I'm going to put some of the compound butter. Okay, our compound butter with our seaweed from DC, alaria and sugar kelp from Cascadia. We have our salmon cooking. I don't want to cook it too fast. So you see, I mean, we just want a small medium heat, slowly. So it's not smoking, it's just cooking slowly. Now the steam is going to help cook the whole salmon very nicely. We have some potato chips that we did. c'est des compounds. Here we are. So remember, we have in our little maple syrup, lemon juice, olive oil dressing here. So compound butter, we can put at the end, we can put a little bit, we can roll a little bit of fresh herbs. It's going to melt on the tornado, and it's going to give a lot of flavor from the seaweed, especially the sugar kelp, who are a little bit sweet à l'arrière. And so those both seaweed are going to... We have seaweed in a condiment, we have seaweed in our compound butter, we have seaweed on our salmon. You see, when you cook, you want a small... fusion, hop. I'm going to take a little tornado. Now I don't need the skin, but you see our skin now stay in. We have our tornado with our nice. So now the butter is going to melt slowly on it. And I can put a little bit, if I want, I can put some of my salmon with some potato chips with some condiment, and that's it. And what I could do, it's little bit of some spicy olive oil to put on that, and that's it. And here we have our salmon dish with compound seaweed butter from Alaria and sugar kelp, who come from Cascadia Seaweed Company. Okay, and so here we have our little salmon dish. The sugar kelp, look at the seaweed, the butter melts on the salmon, then you have the spicy. And if you look at inside, that's the way you want your salmon. You want your salmon medium rare, you see. Just cook, but stay. When you eat it, you should have the sugar kelp. You should have all the spice, so it's sweet, spicy, and your salmon. Very nice.